The three most essential things necessary to sustain life are food, water, and air. Today, all of us know and understand how important these are even for our mere existence. All three are in danger and are becoming scarce. Human beings must take steps to protect, preserve, and conserve these. Land, water, and air are gifts of nature, and it is man's right to enjoy them, but it is also his duty to protect them. Today, let us look at one important resource, that is water. The earth, the air, the land, and the water are not an inheritance from our forefathers, but on loan from our children. So we have to hand over to them at least as it was handed over to us. This quote by Mahatma Gandhi very clearly tells us that the gifts of nature are to be carefully used and preserved. Captain Poseidon and Varun will help us understand about this resource water. Let's join them on their water voyage.
Hello, Varun. Great that you could come and meet me today, though it is raining so heavily.
Yes, sir. It's raining cats and dogs out there. I love the rain and being out in the rain. As a little boy, I would love to jump into puddles. But when we made plans to go out and it would rain, I would get very upset and start singing, "Rain, rain, go away."
Oh, yes. I do love the rain. We have a lot in common. We both love rain. We both like to explore and find out new things. We like reading mystery stories. Is there anything else in common between us?
Sir, we also have a similarity in our names. Yours is Captain Poseidon. And as per Greek mythology, Poseidon is the god of the sea. And as per Hindu mythology, my name, Varun, is also the name of God of the sea.
Now that is fantastic. So we have water as a common factor. So let's explore and find out more about water. Around 72% of our Earth's surface is covered in water. About 60 to 70% of the human body is made up of water.
Yes, water is very important. We cannot live without it. Do you know what the composition of water is?
Look at the picture. It explains the composition of water very clearly. We can see how much is the amount of fresh water available on Earth and also the chemical composition of water. Water is also known by its chemical composition of H2O.
That's very clear. For now on, I will ask for H2O to drink. Can you show me a water cycle?
Of course, you must know the water cycle and how water keeps on getting recharged.
Oh, I have understood what the water cycle is. Let me now share with you some of the uses of water. We need water for agriculture to increase the yield from plants and trees. Water is needed for various industrial processes. We see how water is used in a pulp and paper industry for washing, bleaching, etc. Birds and animals need water for survival and growth. Household needs of people for washing, cooking, cleaning, drinking, bathing, etc. Recreational needs like boating, swimming, water rides, etc.
That's a very detailed list of uses of water. Let's examine the various sources of water. Some of these are rainwater, which recharges the rivers, lakes, oceans, etc. Surface water, Water present on the surface of the earth in forms of oceans, rivers, streams, lakes, etc. The water for these rivers, lakes, etc. comes from the rain and the melting of snow on mountains. Underground water. Rainwater seeps into the soil. Sometimes it comes to the surface in the form of springs. It can be got by digging wells and sinking tube wells, etc. Frozen water. Water which is frozen in the form of glaciers, snow on mountain tops, etc.
Water everywhere, but not a drop to drink anywhere. There is water all around, but the thirsty man can't drink even a drop of water. Why?
The water of the oceans is saline and salty, and so it is not potable or drinkable water. Desalination is needed to make this water into fresh water.
What is desalination?
Desalination is an artificial process of removing the salt and other minerals from the water from seas and oceans. This water is generally saline, and after desalination, it becomes water which can be used by man. But setting up of a desalination plant is very expensive.
It is sad that there is so much of water, but due to misuse and overuse of water, it is becoming scarce. Water is the lifeline of our villages. In fact, in many villages, people have to walk miles just to get one pot of water.
That's very true. Our food comes from the villages. Crops are grown there, so water is needed for irrigation of the fields.
Yes, you can see from the pictures I will show you the different ways they get water. Canals. These canals carry water from the tanks and dams. Tanks. They receive water from the rains. They become dry during drought. We have had man-made tanks through the ages. For this is an ancient water tank built with steps. This is the Chand Bauri in Rajasthan. Wells and tube wells. These have been used for rainwater harvesting from ancient time. For example, the Rani Isvav in Gujarat built around 1050 AD. A Vav is a well in the Gujarati language.
As you've seen in the first picture, it is an old step well. They are filled from rainwater. The second picture is of a modern tube well. Here, pipes are laid into the earth to get groundwater. Electric pumps are used to pump out water from the tube wells.
We have the dams. The tanks, wells and tube wells do not provide adequate water, and not on a regular basis. In the farms and fields, water is needed in plenty and regularly. So water in large quantities is needed. For this, dams are built.
I have visited the Bhakra Nangal Dam in Punjab and the Sri Silam Dam in Andhra Pradesh. You can see the picture of the Sri Silam Dam.
I have heard about many dams. Can you explain to me what is a dam and its various uses?
A dam is a wall built across a river to keep back the water and to raise its level. There is a check on the water flow and it forms a reservoir. This water is carried to the fields through the canals. Dams have many uses. Let's see what some of the uses are. They help store water. They control floods. Some dams are equipped to generate electricity. They help to increase internal navigation. They encourage fish culture. It helps in afforestation and so helps conserve soil. Dams are very scenic and so promote tourism.
Wow! Dams are very useful, aren't they? You have told me about dams, but what are multipurpose projects?
Multipurpose projects are dams built for fulfilling many purposes like controlling floods, generating electricity, etc. These have been termed the temples of modern India by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. let's now examine a few multipurpose projects in India. The Bhakra Nangal project. It is built on the river Satluj in the state of Punjab. It is a joint venture between the states of Punjab, Haryana and Rajasthan. Its purpose is for irrigation and generation of electricity. Special feature, it is the largest dam in India. It is a concrete gravity dam. The Damodar Valley project. It's built on the river Damodar. The Damodar is also called the Sorrow of Bengal. It has four storage dams. It's built jointly by Bihar and West Bengal. It helps in irrigation, power generation, navigation and flood control. Special feature, it is the first multi-purpose river valley project of independent India. The Nagarjun Sagar project. It is built on the river Krishna. It supplies water and produces electricity. Special feature, it is the world's largest masonry dam. The Nagarjun Sagar lake is considered largest man-made lake in the world. The Hirakud project. It is built across the river Mahanadi in Orissa. It helps in irrigation, power generation and flood control. Special feature. It is one of the longest dams in the world and it is the longest dam in India.
I read in the newspapers that the largest dam in the world is the Three Gorges Dam in China.
Yes. It is a massive project.
Wow, it's huge! But there are people who are against these dams. Can you tell me why some people are against them when they are so useful?
Many environmentalists are against the building of dams. The reasons they give are, dams cause greenhouse gas emissions which harm the environment. Dams displace people. They promote erosion. They lead to plant and animal extinction. Dams are not a sustainable solution to many problems.
Water is a renewable source and is replenished perennially. But due to excess pressure on the existing resources, overuse, etc., it is becoming scarce. Let's examine why water is becoming scarce. Overuse of water in households and in agriculture. Excess demand for water in industrial processes. Insufficient rains and so underground water table is getting depleted. Pollution of water due to effluents and wastes being thrown into rivers, lakes, tanks, etc.
We should also look at how to conserve water. Can you suggest some simple ways in which we can conserve water?
Yes, sir. I can suggest a few measures to conserve water. These are, turn off the tap while brushing our teeth. Take shorter showers. Water your lawn and plants in the morning. Don't use a hose to wash your vehicle. Instead, use a bucket and a sponge. Don't throw industrial effluents into the sea or rivers. These are just a few. There will be many more measures we must all adopt, as many as we can.
You have given very good measures to conserve water. Let's look at some slogans and put up some charts all around to increase awareness about how precious water is and our need to conserve it.
Thanks to Captain Poseidon and Varun, we have all had a great water voyage. We have learned so much about water and how precious it is. Time is running out. In fact, the United Nations had dedicated March 23rd as World Water Day. The UN has also declared 2013 as the International Year of Water Conservation. So let us all take a pledge to save every drop of water, because every drop makes the mighty ocean. Well, children, in this class, you have learned about water and its resources and how we could aptly protect our water resources from becoming scarce and extinct. That's all for today. In the next class, we will learn about something else. Till then, see you. Bye-bye.